Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey and you're watching another Photoshop tutorial. Now in this video I'm going to show you how to create this grungy effect using nothing more than the things you find inside of Photoshop. Now originally I made this as a written tutorial for tipsgirl.com, but I got so many requests to make this into a video that, well, I thought it was worth doing. So this is what we're going to create, but of course it all starts out as an ordinary photograph. This is where it begins. So let's get going. First thing I want to do is to make a copy of the background layer. So I'm going to come to Layer and choose Duplicate Layer, or you can use Command or Control J. Either way, you just need a copy like that. But we don't need to do anything with the copy. In fact, I'm going to switch off the visibility for now and click on the background layer to make that active. We'll get back to that copy in due course. Right, let's put a bit more space around the edge of our picture. Now I'm going to increase my canvas size, but before I do, I have to make sure that my canvas that appears is going to be the right colour. So I'm going to press D on the keyboard to hit the default black and white foreground and background colours. Right, having done that, I can go to Image, Canvas Size, and change the units to percent. And I'm going to increase this, 120% in both the width and the height, something like that, and we'll click OK. So now we have a bit more working area, and that's where our grungy border is going to appear. Right, let's make a copy of that layer as well. Let's go to Layer, Duplicate Layer, and click OK, or use Command or Control J, that will work just as well. It's filter time! So let's go grab some filters. I'm going to use Filter, Render, and Clouds. If I can find it, there it is, Clouds, which is a great filter. Nothing to control really other than the colour, and black and white is exactly the colour you want. But I can control how it blends with the layer below, because at the moment it's on normal, which means there is no blending, it's opaque. But if I drop the list down, I can choose Colour Burn, and that's going to blend it in, well, pretty hideously, but don't worry about that, let's keep going, it will get better. Actually, no, it gets worse, but it gets worse and then it gets better. So let's make a copy of that layer as well. We'll go to Layer, Duplicate Layer, or Command or Control J. And once again, we'll use a filter. So, Filter, Render, and this time, Fibers. Now, Fibers is another brilliant filter for creating kind of grungy and textured effects. I'm going to set the Variance to 5 and the Strength to 1. You can always hit Randomize a few times if you like to create a randomized type of fiber effect, but when you're happy, click OK, and that puts that kind of streaky fiber effect on the picture. Now, I'm going to change the blend mode of this one, so it's no longer color burn, it's going to be color dodge. And you get, as promised, an even worse looking picture. Nah, don't worry, it will get better very quickly. In fact, let's start improving things right now. Remember that layer that we duplicated right at the beginning and switched off? Well, now it's time to switch it back on. So I'll turn the visibility back on. I'll click the layer so it's active, and I'm going to put a little border around the inside of the picture. So I'm going to come to Layer, Layer Style, and choose Stroke. And the stroke will put the border on the inside, but you do have to make sure the position is set to inside, the color is set to black, and then increase the size. How much of a border? Well, that will depend on the picture you're using. I'm going to use something like 65, but you may find you need to use a bigger number or a smaller number depending on the number of pixels in your image. I'll click OK. Okay, so that's added in the little effect, and now I'm ready to add in the grunge around the outside. So I'm going to click on the background layer, make that active, and then I'm going to use another filter. And I'm going to use the blurring ability of Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Now, at a low level, it really has no impact whatsoever. In fact, as you bring it up, you have very little effect. And then you get sort of halfway along, and you can start to see the grunge building up. And this is where it starts to become a personal preference thing. How much grunge do you want? Well, as you blur the background layer, so your grungy border becomes bigger and more obvious. I like a lot, so let's go put it way up towards the top end of things like that. So now we have this nice grungy effect building up. If you want to improve it further or add more sort of grunge coming around the edge, what you do is grab a paintbrush, choose a fairly darkish grey, not pure black, not pure white, somewhere in the middle, and then paint. And as you paint around the edges, you'll get more grunge appearing. I'm using a nice kind of soft brush, and we're just going to use a few clicks. The more you paint, the more harder and more grungy it appears to be, like that. So we'll just add in a couple of selective areas, like so. Now, if it's gone a little bit hard somewhere, you can always swap to white as your foreground colour and push it back in again, like that. There you go. Lovely. And we can reverse the grunging effect. And you can build it up by swapping and painting different colours. Ooh, a little bit much on the corner. Swap to white, paint it back in. And there you go. There's how you can completely make your very own grungy effect. And I've used nothing more than you had already inside of Photoshop or even Photoshop Elements. I'm Gavin Hoey. If you want to find out any more about me, visit my website at www.gavtrain.com. Thanks for watching.